The asteroid that killed the non-avian dinosaurs was obviously huge. It measured about 10 to 15 kilometers in diameter and left a crater twice as wide as Los Angeles that's now submerged in the Gulf of Mexico. But what if I told you there is an even bigger crater from an even bigger asteroid that hit the Earth long before the dinosaurs ever existed? Allow me to introduce you to the Vreede Fort impact structure. It's held the record for the world's biggest crater for 2 billion years. I know, the Vreede Fort impact structure doesn't look much like a crater today. But 2 billion years ago, one of the biggest asteroids to ever strike the Earth crashed into South Africa, not too far from what is now Johannesburg. The crater is estimated to be around 280 kilometers wide. And I say estimated because the crater itself has eroded quite a bit over the years. All that degradation makes it hard to get an exact measurement of its original size. In order to make a crater that large, the asteroid would have had to be about 25 kilometers across and moving around 15 kilometers per second. Basically, a rock the size of a small town traveling faster than a fighter jet. This was likely the largest impact the Earth had seen since its earliest days in the Hadean period, about 4 billion years ago. Back then, the planet was getting pelted with giant rocks all the time because the solar system was still forming. It's hard to even imagine the explosive force of the asteroid that hit South Africa. Rocks from that impact site have been found as far away as modern-day Russia. Of course, our continents were all lumped together in a supercontinent 2 billion years ago, so those spots would have been more like 2,000 kilometers apart, as opposed to 10,000. But throwing a rock 2,000 kilometers is still pretty impressive. Life was still in the early stages at the time, but cyanobacteria were new on the scene and had just begun photosynthesizing and pumping oxygen into the atmosphere. And just because there weren't any bona fide plants and animals yet doesn't mean everything was fine for life the day of the impact. Given that this happened 2 billion years ago, we'll never truly know exactly how microbial life was affected by such a huge space rock. But we do have information from other impacts that can help us get an idea of what may have happened. For example, the asteroid that killed the non-avian dinosaurs 66 million years ago, kicked up so much dust into the atmosphere that it plunged the world into a years-long winter when it essentially blocked out the sun. Cyanobacteria are photosynthetic, meaning they need sunlight to make their food. So you can imagine how a years-long winter would have potentially set life back. The impact wouldn't have just affected our little microbe buddies or thrown rocks across a continent, though. It also left behind some pretty interesting markers of the impact site itself. Like I mentioned earlier, the crater itself is mostly eroded, so the most obvious evidence of a space rock hitting our planet is hard to see. But what about that dome in the center of the crater? For a long time, scientists believed this was the result of volcanic activity. That is, until they found shatter cones in the surrounding rocks. These are, believe it or not, cone-shaped rocks that look shattered, with lots of cracks, lines, and fissures running through them. Shatter cones form when the shock waves of the impact radiate through the surrounding rock. That creates these interesting crack patterns, with the narrow part of the cone pointing towards the impact site. It's like an arrow directing you to the site of a catastrophe. Shatter cones are widely accepted to be a diagnostic feature of dramatic impacts, such as nuclear explosions or asteroid strikes, which means that the dome was the result of an impact. But how on Earth, literally, would something hitting the planet cause something to protrude from the impact site?
This SciShow video is supported by Jump, a statistical analysis software that makes powerful analytics quick and accessible. Jump's interface is easy to use because everything is point and click, but it just got even easier. Now even the back-end scripting interface is automated, so you can integrate your data processing with systems already in place, like R, Python, Excel, and more. And it happens immediately, so you get real-time data analysis. I know, it sounds like you'd need to be an expert computer scientist to make all of that happen, but you don't need programming know-how to take advantage of Jump's back-end tech. You don't even need to write out lines of code. Jump's scripts and workflows can be saved from a graph or other output. Then you can automatically include them in your original data table so you can reuse it as many times as you want. That also means that as you add data, update the dataset, and clean it up, your code will keep working. So Jump optimizes and streamlines your data analysis without reinventing the wheel. And Jump offers a 30-day free trial for anyone, anywhere. So to see the benefits of visual statistics for yourself, you can go to jmp.com/scishow.
When the asteroid hit, the impact would have produced such high temperatures and pressures that it allowed rock to flow in a way rocks don't usually flow. The impact created a rebound of the surrounding rock in the same way that a drop of water would create a rebound on a flat and calm surface of water. But that's not even the coolest part. The rebounded rock brought a craton up closer to the surface of Earth's current crust. Cratons are the roots of continents, and they're made up of some of the oldest continental crust that exists. And thanks to erosion at the site, this craton has been exposed, allowing researchers to investigate the geology of the Earth 3 billion years ago. Now, I know I've mentioned erosion of the area several times. The 3-4 impact site is less and less recognizable as a crater as time goes on. That's because wind, water, and glaciers have been breaking down its original structure. Earth's tendency to recycle its own rock isn't helping preserve the site either. The movement of tectonic plates causes Earth's crust to dip below other crust, pushing it back into the mantle for it to be turned back into magma and recycled into new crust later on. This doesn't happen on many other celestial bodies like Mars and the Moon. And you may have noticed they have more craters than Earth. For several reasons, craters just stick around longer on some planets. The 3-4 impact structure won't be around forever. But for now, it's a UNESCO World Heritage Site. You can even take a tour of the gorgeous landscape and all its wacky space rock-induced geological features. So go visit before it disappears. Then again, it took 2 billion years for it to get to this point, so you've probably got some time before it's gone for good.